Now, what is RFM? We divide RFM into three parts. One is called recency, another is called frequency, another is called monetary values. Recency means, suppose you given some target, some assignment to everybody, some people are ready to take accept the challenges, some people are not saying no to that job, some people are saying, okay, I will do that. So now, what the recency score is, the most important factor in identifying employee who are likely to respond a new assignment. We call it a recency. When he received an accepted recency. Okay, suppose what happened, there is some employee who has accepted challenges 4 months back. Now, when I'm interested to do some work, they'll not come forward. So, and those who are already taken challenges today, they have to yesterday also, and 3 months back. So, people are, different kinds of people are there. I want to know who are the people who take challenges at the moment. Suppose there are three employees. 1, 2, 3. Employee number 3 always take challenges, assignment. Whenever I give some assignment, he accepted and do that accordingly. Employee number 2, he has taken some assignment 2 months back, but now he's not ready to take any new assignment. He's refused that. Number 1 employee, he just take one assignment recently, but he does not have anything prior experience on that assignment. So first thing you need to know, their last assignment when he's taken. What is the first one? Essentially means when he accepted the last assignment. Second is called frequency. How many times a person accepted assignment? 2 times, 10 times, 5 times, 1 time, like this. So one is when he accepted his last assignment. Number 2 is how many times he accepted his assignment. And 3rd is how much money he given to the organizations in terms of sales, in terms of whatever it may be. It means what is the role of contribution to the monetary or investment financial contribution to the organization. So there are 3 things. One is called R, another is called F, another is called M. R means the last assignment he has taken. F means number of assignment he has taken. M means the monetary benefit he is given to the organizations. Now see, suppose first take about R. First is called employee ID. Then second, now this employee ID, this is called his recency, means last assignment suppose there are one employee number 1, he has taken last assignment accepted 7/8/2018. 2 is taken 1/1/2019. 3rd, he has taken last assignment 5/3/2018. Like this, I'm having the employee of 500/2/2018. Now, once you got all the information, what I will do, suppose I'm having 500 people, that will be 600 people. I divide whole part, suppose I'll do ascending. Ranking of recency. Just write down ranking of recency. Those who are writing something, you can write ranking. मैंने क्या किया? सारे को मैंने ascending order कर दिया. Ascending order means सबसे जो main रहेगा पहला वो रहेगा number 1 and सबसे जो last में रहेगा 1/1/2018. For example, let me explain one thing. Wait. Okay. I will open Excel. Excel लेटा ले रहा हूँ. Is देखा जा रहा है आपको सर एक्सेल डाटा आ रहा है
यस यस वी आर गेटिंग इट
ओके नाउ दिस इज कॉल्ड एम्प्लॉई आईडी दिस इज कॉल्ड आईडी दिस इज हिज लास्ट असाइनमेंट आर दिस इज द नंबर ऑफ असाइनमेंट एफ दिस इज द मॉनिटरी वैल्यू इज गिवन टू एम लेट मी एक्सप्लेन स्टॉप शेयर स्क्रीन एक्सेल इज इट क्लियर नाउ इज विजिबल नाउ ID 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Like this, I'm having an employee of, let me 30. Clear? Now R, he's taken assignment 1/1/2018. He's taken last assignment 20. He's taken the last assignment 1/3/2020. Like this, 1/4/2020. Like this. Is it clear? Now it is visible now. So first one is ID, second one is date, third is number, fourth is money. Is it clear now?
Clear.
So first thing is, I have to do recency score. Write down recency score. जो लोग एक्सेल नहीं करते हैं तो आप थोड़ा मुझसे देखो मैं कैसे काम करता हूँ, देन आई विल सेव द डाटा. नाउ व्हाट आई विल डू, देन फर्स्ट आई डू द असेंडिंग, एंड असेंडिंग करूंगा लोएस्ट टू हाईएस्ट, हाईएस्ट टू लोएस्ट. नाउ दिस इज 14 14 15 लाइक दिस. मेरे पास क्या हुआ, ये असेंडिंग ऑर्डर में आ गया. देन व्हाट हैपेंड, आई विल डिवाइड द होल डाटा इनटू फाइव पार्ट्स, इनटू फाइव पार्ट्स. सो हाउ मेनी डाटा आई एम हैविंग, 41. So, एक-एक सेट में कितने लोग रहेंगे? Anybody? एक-एक सेट में कितने लोग रहेंगे? Suppose I'm having 40 number of employees. First, I collected the when he's taken the last assignment. Second, how many assignment he's taken. Third, what is the monetary contribution of that employee? I am getting three information just now. Now, first thing is, you first जो date आपके recency date के हैं, आप उसको ascending करेंगे. A to Z ascending order, that is called A to Z. Now, first five, which is called most recent customer, you score five. We give score 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5. Next group 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4. Next group 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3. Next group, I will give 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. And last, I will give score 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. It means, what is the first step? First, to ascending the recency based upon the last assignment, जो presently जो लिया हुआ है, currently जो लिया हुआ है, इसको हम score दे रहे हैं 5. इसका पिछले जो लिया हुआ है, इसको देंगे 4. मतलब इसका मतलब है, you are having 200 employee, you divide it into 5 groups, each group you are having 40. So first 40 you give the score 5, second 40 you give the score of, first give 4, 5, second you give the 4, third you give the score 3, like this. Any doubt up to this? Now, second, what I'll do, I will again monetary ko main phir se kya karunga, number of assignment ko phir se main ascending order mein jaunga, largest to smallest. Jo sabse largest hoga, I will give the score 5, first group 5, next 4, next 3. थोड़ा मैं ये कर रहा हूं तो आप इसको देख लेना, एग्जैक्टली डिवाइड करोगे. नेक्स्ट 2 एंड लास्ट 1 एंड थर्ड अगेन आई विल डू द मॉनेटरी वैल्यू, हाउ मच मनी इज गिवन. आई विल गो बाय असेंडिंग ऑर्डर, लार्जेस्ट टू स्मॉलेस्ट. दोज हु स्पेंड गिव मोर अमाउंट, दैट इज कॉल्ड फ्रीक्वेंसी स्कोर, एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड मनी. आई गिव स्कोर 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5. देन 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, then 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, then 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, like this. ये थोड़ा कैलकुलेशन ही होगा, थोड़ा आपको एग्जैक्टली देखना है. Now tell me what, suppose then you calculate RFM score. RFM score, which is equal to, write down the formula, 100 into R, 100 into R plus 10 into F, 10 multiplied F plus 1 into M. 1 into M. Tell, so what is the maximum score, anybody? What should the maximum score? We can say how much maximum score can be. 5, 5, 5, 5. So, okay. Now formula is, I will explain 100 into R, 100 into R, then 10 into F and 1 into M. Let me explain what I मैं क्या करना क्या कर रहा क्या था. First मेरे पास तीन information रह रहा है. One is called date, when he's taken last assignment. So what is my objective? My objective is, suppose एक employee 3 महीना पहले assignment लिया है और इसके बाद नहीं लिया है, और employee 10 महीना पहले ले रहा है assignment नहीं लिया, एक employee recently ले रहा है, तो रिसेंट जो स्कोर होगा हम इसको 5 देंगे, बिकॉज आई वांट रिटेन दे. और जो 10 महीने बाद आ रहा है तो ये मेरे लिए इतना और सी नहीं है. सो बेस्ड अपॉन द नंबर ऑफ असाइनमेंट, द डे ऑफ असाइनमेंट टेकन, मैं सॉर्टिंग कर रहा हूँ. सॉर्टिंग करने के बाद जो फर्स्ट ब्लॉक रहेगा रिसेंट वाला को मैंने एग्जैक्टली, बिकॉज आई डिवाइडेड होल ग्रुप इन टू 5 पार्ट, फर्स्ट पार्ट आई गिव द 5, नेक्स्ट 4, देन 3, देन 2, देन 1. Then what I did, the number of assignments taken, how many assignments is taken during that 1 year or 2 year. Then the highest, then I divided in sorting order, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. How much money is given to the organization in sorting order, okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Then I calculate the formula, 100 into R, 10 into F, 1 into N. Now tell me, who is the best employee? If the score is 1, 1, 1, the score is 5, 5, 5. What is the difference between these two? 1, 1, 1 score means the person has taken assignment much time before, and frequency is very less. He's not willing to work, take the assignment, and his monetary contribution is very bad. Do you think that employee is worthy for your organization? Yes or no? No. What is 5, 5, 5 score? 5, 5, 5 means a person who has recently taken assignment, the frequency is always in the first cluster, highest number, and his contribution toward is high. So do you think it is a more worthy employee of your organization? Yes. So what I did, accordingly, I divided the whole part into 5 parts. Suppose I say 1, 1, 5. What does it mean? It means the person who has taken assignment much more time before, frequency is very less, but its contribution is high. Whenever he did any job, he did very good job. So what is your strategy? Means he is a very good performer, but maybe his motivation level bahut kam hai. क्योंकि इसको अच्छा एम्प्लॉई है बट इसको कोई लीडरशिप मोटिवेट नहीं कर पा रहा है, इसीलिए जो एक बार चैलेंज इसको मिला था वो अच्छा कंट्रीब्यूशन किया था. सो वी हैव टारगेट दो टाइप एम्प्लॉई, व्हिच इज ओके, ही मे बी एक्सीलेंट परफॉर्मर बट इज नॉट टेकन एंड इज नॉट रेडी टू टेक एनी असाइनमेंट एंड हिज फ्रीक्वेंसी इज वेरी लो हियर. सो ऑन बेसिस ऑफ दिस स्कोर आई डिवाइडेड होल ग्रुप इनटू डिफरेंट कस्टमर. सपोज आई विल से स्कोर इज 5, 5, 1. व्हाट डज इट मीन?
Recently, he has taken many assignments.
Yes, he has recently taken assignment. He has high number of assignment, but his contribution toward the organization is very, very lowest. So, what is the problem here? Problem is he is a very good employee. He is a loyal employee to us, but he is not contributing so much what others are people doing. So, he needs training. So, based upon this categorical employee, you have to divide the strategy to whom you train, to whom you give incentives, suppose if his score is 1, 1, 1, what does it mean? He has taken assignment much more time before, he is not able to take any assignment, his frequency is very less, his contribution is very less. So do you retain this type of employee or you want to say goodbye? So you say goodbye. So now, and based upon these numbers, I got 1, 5, 5, it's very good, high monetary contribution, but now see the case number 1, 5, 5. So what type of employee he is? Because before explaining the concept, you should know what is 1, 5, 5. What type of employee he has been taken number of assignment and contribution is good. So it means to target that he's a good performer, but he's not willing to take new assignment because he has taken assignment much more before. Maybe some problem. So you require counseling for that type of employee. So the HR people are using this thing to understand their behavior based upon the 3 things. You require 3 things. On basis of that, they will apply the different HR strategy. I hope it is clear now. Okay, now Dr. Anjana, you are asking you can divide group into any number. Depends. Now see, SPSS has you, if you are applying SPSS, it's taken maximum 9 groups. Okay, now if your data set is very high, suppose 3,000 employee, 4,000 employee, then divide 9 groups. If data size is very less, 50, 100, 200, 300, better you go for 5 groups. So it is up to you what group you have to take. If you say 9 groups, then your score will be 999. 999 means he's a very good performer. So it is up to you how you will decide. But now SPSS will help you to analyze everything with the one concept. So recency I explained. But now recency, the time employee most recent target achieved. I give the 5 score. Not recent at all is 1. Not recent is 2. Somewhat recent is 3. 4 is 4, recent is 4, and 5 is very recent. So these are the scale you are using, okay, for recency. And the specific cutoff point depends upon the specific HR campaigning and decided by HR team. Can score lega, you take 5 or 5 based upon your scale, you can target, okay. Now, second is called frequency. So what is the frequency value? To take not frequently at all, 2 means 2, not frequent, 3 somewhat frequent, 4 is frequent, 5 very frequent. So even suppose if a person whose score is 1, 1 and 1 and 5, 5, 5, 2, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3. Now, I will say, sir, I have 1,000 employees, so a lot of numbers will come. How I will analyze? Don't worry, SPSS will help you to analyze such type of things within 1 second. Now, next is called monetary value. In monetary value also, what is the objective? Very small target money achieved, small amount target money achieved, normal target money achieved, four larger target money achieved, and very large target money achieved. So now we understand, 5 year is very frequent, 5 year is very recent, and 5 year is very large target. So I hope now understand the concept. On basis of these three score, we would find out the results. Now, how to compute a frequency, and now we calculate the index. These are called index. I've taken 1, 1, 1, 5, 5, 5. These are called index. So if the score, now just you ask, tell me 3, 1, 3. What does it mean?
Monetary is very high. That implies
monetary is not very high. Monetary is average.
Hmm.
But frequency is very low.
Yeah.
And his second assignment is with 2 months before. So what type of employee is? What is the behavior of such employee? It means he may be worthy, but it's not explaining. He's not giving full 100% to the organization. Clear? Since the frequency is low because he's not ready to take any assignment voluntarily, and so it means there is some problem. You just ask the person and counseling what is the problem. It may be problem with his family. Maybe problem is the leadership. Maybe problem is the immediate manager, because he's a good person, but due to something. 3, 1, 3, it means this score is very less, so you need a counseling for that. So the most interesting thing is that you calculate this HR index, isko bolte hain employment performance index through RFM. You can write one paper on that. That is EPI on RFM. EPI means employment performance index on through RFM. Okay. Now these are the different types of employees. You are saying champions, loyal employees, potential loyalists, recent achievers, promising employees, employee needing attention, about to sleep, risk employee, can't lose them, and hibernating. Okay, now tell me, who is the champion?
High value employees, 555, 999, like that.
Oh, right. So it means those employees score is 555, they are champion employees. So you should retain them, you should give incentive to them, you should give more challenges or more assignment to them. Who are the loyal employees? Loyal employee means 5, 5. This to be 5, 5. It may be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Doesn't matter. मतलब ये recent ले रहा है and always challenge ले रहा है. But based upon 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you need strategy. If it is 4, if it is 3, you need training. If it is 2, give some leadership. Some इसको team में डालना, group में डालना है. So based upon this, then what is potential loyalist employee? Anybody?
Yeah, participants are saying 444.
444, yeah, very good. 444 is right. Now tell me, who is the risk employee? 111. What is about to sleep? 115. 114. 113. These are called about to sleep because they are very good performer, but due to some leadership, maybe I'm wrong. Due to some leadership problem or this self problem, they are not taking an assignment. They are about to sleep. And can't lose them is always 155. Sorry, 55515. Means recent customer, recently challenged liya and high performer. So you target upon 5X and 5, you target them. Those recent and having high monetary value of 5 or 4, don't lose them. You just keep training them and to need them. What is called hibernating? Anybody, what is called hibernating employee?
511.
This is 111. This is about to sleep means 111 ho sakta hai, 113 ho sakta hai, 212 ho sakta hai. These are about to sleep, 212 ho sakta hai, but these people are 111, these people are 555. Now, I hope the concept is clear. You can apply this concept and divide the whole employee into different groups, and based upon the group, you give some strategy. Now, see, this is called a tree map. So, and this is, RFM will give this tree map. Now, what happened? Based upon all employees, I found this figure. Anybody can explain, do you think that the employees are good? These are the value I got. This is tree map. This is the size of this. This is the size of this. 1,372 employees are risk employee. 1,277 are attention. 67 are refresh. But recently they have joined an assignment. Loyalist is 2,914. Company is only 119. Okay. Lost is 2,345. That's the biggest number. Okay. And hibernating is 168. So you just lay up, इनको हटाना पड़ेगा, इनको warning देना पड़ेगा, इनको incentive देना पड़ेगा, इसको team में के मोटिवेट करना पड़ेगा, ट्रेनिंग देना पड़ेगा. सो बेस्ड अपॉन दिस टाइप ऑफ अटेंशन यू गिव योर स्ट्रेटजी. यू टेक 3 or 4 ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ओके टू कैलकुलेट द आरएफएम स्कोर और देन यू एनालाइज ओके व्हिच ऑर्गेनाइजेशन डूइंग गुड और आई कैन टेक विद इन नीश आल्सो. आई कैन गो फॉर एमबीए डिपार्टमेंट, बीटेक डिपार्टमेंट, अदर डिपार्टमेंट. आई कैलकुलेट द नंबर ऑफ क्लासेस इज टेकन, व्हेन इज व्हाट इज द टोटल परसेंटेज ऑफ रिजल्ट, मॉनिटर इज इक्वल टू रिजल्ट, फ्रीक्वेंसी मींस हाउ मेनी टाइम ही कंडक्टेड हिज क्लासेस. An assignment means what the new topic is taken, new subject is taken. You always take new, then I go for one. So if based upon this, you can do the RFM analysis for your employee. I have already given one data sheet. Everybody please open the data sheet. That is called data RFM. So once you open the data, please go to the last one. The last one is for information about employees. Now employee ke baad last one dekho, date, most recent, frequency and amount. 3 things should be there in your data set.
Yes, recency score and frequency score and monetary score.
It is not score. It is the actual data.
Okay.
Means 2014 में last assignment लिया था. अभी तक इस साल 8 assignment कर चुका है. Total contribution to organization 8,000. You can change the RFM with the new variable. अगर मैं faculty लूँगा तो मैं देखूँगा कितना feedback आ रहा है इसका, कितना बार new hours से class कर रहा है. Okay. इतना न्यू सब्जेक्ट ले रहा है, हर वक्त न्यू सब्जेक्ट ले रहा है, 2 सब्जेक्ट तो आई गिव 5, नहीं ले रहा है तो 1, लाइक दिस आई कैन. तो आरएफएम डिपेंड्स अपॉन योर इंटरप्रिटेशन एंड योर इंटरेस्ट. ओके, दिस इज ओनली एन इंडिकेटिव आल्सो. नाउ सी द डाटा सेट. डाटा में क्या हो, गो टू द वेरिएबल व्यू. नाउ दिस आर द इंस्टीट्यूशन, क्वालिफिकेशन, एवरीथिंग, टैक्स डिडक्शन, लोन इंस्टॉलमेंट, चिल्ड्रन एजुकेशन कमिटमेंट, सेविंग बैंक, एनपीएस, जीपीएफ, सारा डाटा अवेलेबल है. और मुझे इंटरेस्ट नहीं है इसका डिटेल्स, मुझे चाहिए मोस्ट ये 3 चीज, कितना बार वो लास्ट असाइनमेंट कब लिया था, कितना असाइनमेंट है कंप्लीट कर चुका है अभी तक और कितना कंट्रीब्यूशन है. तो प्लीज गो टू डायरेक्ट, देयर इज अ कॉल डायरेक्ट मार्केटिंग. यहाँ डायरेक्ट मार्केटिंग होगा, उसको क्लिक करिए, चूज टेक्निक. यहाँ पर एक आरएफएम आएगा, क्लिक आरएफएम. देयर इज कॉल्ड ट्रांजेक्शन डाटा, देयर इज कस्टमर डाटा. आई एम गो फॉर एम्प्लॉय डाटा, देयर इज कॉल्ड कस्टमर डाटा. क्लिक कस्टमर डाटा एंड कंटिन्यू. नाउ व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट वन. First, I want to go for transaction date. मतलब date of is recent. इसको मैं क्लिक करूंगा. कुछ नहीं करना है. Date को वहां पर क्लिक करना. Last one, go to last one जाइए. Date most recent. Then number of targets, amount, and last one is called serial number of the employee. Once you prepare this 4 set, then go to the billing. Now see, यहां पर लिखा है कितना ग्रुप बनाना है. 5 ग्रुप बनाना है ना? 6, 7, 8, 9. मुझे कितना ग्रुप बनाना है? 5. So I want 5, 5, 5. Then go to the same. I want recency score, frequency score, monetary score in my data set. Then go to the output. I want table, histogram, and scatter plot. Dobara bol raha hu. Go to the variable. Sara date humne dala transaction date mein, number of frequency dal diya, number of transaction mein, amount mein dal diya, and employee identification is maine dalne ke baad. I go to the beginning. I want 5, 5, 5 score. You can go for 3 also, you can go for 9 also, it is up to you. For standard, you go for 5. Then go to the save. I want recency score, frequency score, and monetary score. Go to the output. I want heat map, chart bean, table, histogram, and scatter plot. When you see OK, now see the last part is the score. Yeah, score again. Now see, अगर आपको 1000 employees है, that is very difficult to find out one on, तो automatically आपको SPSS बना बना के दे रहा है. What is 551? Very recently he has taken assignment and he's always taken more of assignment, but is contributing very less. So what is your strategy to give that particular employee?
Oh, that's the HR interpretation.
Yeah. So I will explain one by one. Let me conclude the output also. Then I'll go for the demography. So I hope it is clear now. We got all the score now.
Great.
So based upon this, you can maybe इसको मैं copy कर रहा हूँ. I have taken 2 things here for understanding.
People are saying they should be counseled.
Okay. I have copied this. I have taken Excel. Excel में ले रहा हूँ. I paste here and I've taken these are the employees 1, 2, and 3. Now based on that, मैंने क्या किया? I got this number. This is called serial employee and this is called anybody. This is called ID and this is called score. Now, once I got this ID and score, what I did, just I went to the largest to smallest. Now I got a score. So I got these three employee number 192, 408 and 493. They are my very good employee and they are my champions. Am I right or not?
People are saying that if it is 444, then also it is quite close.
Yeah, you divide in four group. Na? These are the champion. Now 554. So all this. Suppose I said there is 551. What is a 551? Anybody? 551. Recent, more and what monetary contribution very, very less. So based upon this, you divide the different cluster and put the, you five, suppose those are five. These are what is the five here? I have taken this five group. These are the recent. Okay, now this up to this. Now see, these are the recent one. All 555, then middle 555 like this. So now it is up to you. How HR people are taking this thing, it is up to you. What I will suggest to the management, can you explain, anybody? The employee number one is score 551. What does it mean? What type of employee he is?
The people are asking that against which benchmark you can compare the employees.
Okay, now see, I've already explained the benchmark. R, A, N, is it clear? Mm. A means the total monetary given to me, good for me, high frequency of assignment is good for me, and more recent is good for me. That is my benchmark. Okay. Suppose if the person was taken assignment 6 months before, and frequency is very less, is not taken any account, and monetary is very less. Now the qualitative interpretation ko main indexing kar raha hu aur kuch nahi kar raha hu. All this qualitative information I am calculating the index. Is it clear? Now I'll explain the output about any Excel bhi kuch samajh aa raha hai. Suppose main bol raha hu mere paas 391 ko mujhe kya karna hai? Can I go for training? Can I go for appraisal or incentive? Can I go for layoff? What I will do? And what about this person? One to one. What is the anybody who can explain these persons? Is good employer, bad employee, or organization? Anybody?
One to one. How he can be good employee?
That's why. Right. That is the score. Because now I got this score. I asked them. This is the your score is very less because you have not taken any assignment nearby. Your frequency is very less. And you are not contributing to the organization any way. So please go out. Thank you very much. They are low performer. Is it clear?
People are also saying he can be a fresher.
Fresher means how is the fresher? If it's fresher means he taken five, na? Mm-hmm. When the assignment or he can 1 to 1, but what it means last assignment is 5 months. When you compare among all the employees, he has taken the assignment in 1, 2, or 3 months before. And sabse last aa raha hai, to fresher kaise hoga ye? Is it clear now?
Right.
When you compare. Of 1,000 employee, if his score is our score is 1, it means what? He's not taken any assignment latestly. He has taken assignment more before. Hmm. Even though fresher, if it is fresher, I give 1. Listen, if it is a fresher, I score 1. I score give 5. Maybe then I, this is maybe 1. And this may be 1. This may be 1 or maybe 2 or maybe 3 or maybe 4 or maybe 5. Is it clear now? If it is a fresher, then this score may be very, but this score should be 5. If the fresher, this score should be 5 because recent he's taken an assignment. If fresher aa raha hai bhi kuch assignment nahi le raha hai, now you need to counseling.
Yeah, another confusion is there. Suppose the workload is not evenly distributed in the company.
That may be. Listen, sir. Now see how HR people will be analyze the things. It is up to you.
Absolutely.
You are my. The objective is I given a score to you based upon their database. Now, how you will cook? How you will analyze? What whether you go layoff, go training, or incentive? Let me explain through SPSS. It will give more picture clear. Now, see out of employees, this score, frequency score, monetary score, and R score. Is it clear now? R is here 1, 1. The frequency is 2, 3, 4, 5, and monetary 1, 2, 3, 5. Now, recency score is 5, frequency is 5, and monetary is 5. How much candidate are there? Anybody? 5 recency, 5 frequency, and 5 monetary. How many candidate are there? जो आपने एक्सेल में कैलकुलेट किए थे ना सर असेंडिंग कर रहे थे वो वैल्यू टेबल में आ गया. देखो देयर आर ओनली थ्री पीपल हुज हु आर चैंपियन टू मी. एम आई क्लियर? रिसेंट, मोस्ट फ्रीक्वेंट एंड हाई वैल्यूज. रिसेंट मे बी फ्रेशर, दिस मे बी फ्रेशर, फाइव मे बी फ्रेशर, बट नाउ सी फोर इज फोर, दिस इज द स्कोर 5157 525 553. सो नाउ टेल मी इफ दिस इज द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, what is your conclusion? Anybody? What is your conclusion? Which segment is highest in number? If I would say 1, 1, 1 and 5, this is 19 people, 20 people, 19, 23, 19. Tell me, evenly distributed है वो हरा हर मेरे जितने employees हैं सारा इसमें distributed हो रहा है. Is it clear? Now who are the champion and who are the hibernating? Anybody? This group 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 9. 1, 2, 2, 9, 1, 2, 3, 7. These are the these are difficult employee or difficult employee for me. I need to train them. I ask, I find the score, I go to the profiles, then I will do it. Okay. Now see, this is the data set. Go to the RFM, customer data. Right. You got all the information. Is it clear?
Right.
Then yeah, ma 3-3 liya maine. Mm-hmm. You got the score. RFM score is here. Now this is the data set. You got this result. मेरे थोड़ा problem आ रहा है. तो anybody can explain this figure? This R recency and Mandarika scatter, Mandarin frequency scatter, frequency recency scatter. Anybody can explain? Anybody? What exactly it says? This is recency value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Mandarin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Mandarin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Frequency 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Anybody can explain? It whether employees are very good or they are scattered or they are anything you want in your mind. It's monetary 5 and recency 3. Only one customer is there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is only one customer who is an average. Okay? So, the monetary, it means monetary mein hum log bahut contribution nahin kar pa rahe employees hai. But recency, there are more fresher custom employees are there. Frequency is also very scattered and recency frequency very scattered. It means these people are need to be motivated. Because whereas the recency frequency are highly scattered, so it means the leaderships are not doing good. But exactly in my point of view, maybe different. You got this score also. Anybody who can explain this graph? So do you think this organization is doing very good? Whether the employees are contributing more or less? They're contributing very less. The frequency is very less. But most customers are very recent employees. They have taken recent challenges. Okay, and there are few employees are having the recency, low recency value. So what is the conclusion? That the people are taking assignment, but their frequency is very low and the monetary is very low. So what is the objective? I need to give the training to them because the leadership is not doing good. They're not motivated the employees to get a more monetary benefit or they're not ready to take any challenges. But however, they've taken recent challenges. Now this is another way. This is called heat map. These are the monetary contribution. This is frequency 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Recency 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So जहाँ पर blue ज़्यादा dark रहेगा, that is good. This is called champion. एक अलग data लिया मैंने, ये champion. I have seen frequency is 5 and monetary is 5 में this company is doing very good in compared to this. There are four company data लिया, 1, 2, 3, 4. This company is very bad because not as this group mein jo hyper is main group mein hit nahi ho raha hai, blue zyada nahi hai. But 1 and 2, this 1 and this 4, these two are very good organization because most of the employees are contributing large in numbers and most hit are is here, koi scattered nahi hai. Like this would analyze the RFM. This hit map means, now see, very important point. This is frequency 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, recency 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And within monetary, okay, this is monetary 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now this 5 and 5 and 5, this is called 5, 5, 5. Now this score, this scale is if it is high, blue in number, it's going to be very good. मतलब बहुत लोग अच्छा काम कर रहे हैं. यहाँ पर 5, 5, 5 नहीं है. यहाँ पर 5, 5, 5 ज़्यादा है. यहाँ पर 5, 5 इतना light लिए. In compared to this, what I concluded that frequency is very good. 5 में ज़्यादा hit हो रहा है and monetary भी ज़्यादा hit हो रहा है. तो 5, 5, 5, 4 में ज़्यादा लोग हैं. But this, in compared to this, this is a very good organization because, and this is a very bad organization. This is very bad organization because we have not contributed anything from this employee. this one. But now I will explain to the example. So it is so right. Okay, lastly, I will again explain direct. Go to direct marketing, use technique, go to RFM, click customer data, then click transaction, last one transaction, then number of transaction, then amount and ID. Then go to the winning. I want 555 score. Go to the save. I want RFM score. Go to the output. I want tableau count, histogram, and scatter plot. This is the result I'm getting.
But you know, if people bias is there in segmenting or assigning the values to the people, then everything goes bad.
No. It depends upon a lot of. For example, I'll explain. I will explain this one. Scales in data. Now see, अभी मैं इसको किसका नाम चेंज करूँगा जो फाइव आ रहा है ना हेलो
यस
फाइव आई गो टू द वेरिएबल व्यू सो हियर आई विल रिसेंसी स्कोर फाइव
ओके
मैं आई विल से फाइव मींस व्हाट इज द फाइव एनीबॉडी
वो तो मैक्सिमम ना वेरी
रिसेंट नाउ आई विल एग्जांपल व्हाट इज फोर फोर मींस रिसेंट
Recent.
Three average, moderate. Two.
Not recent.
And one not recent at all. Now when I click this, now please go to the.
Add that one. One you add.
One, not recent at all. Not recent at all. Now see, add मैंने किया like this आप कोई कर सकते हो अभी यहाँ पर मैं देखो I got the score. Now you got the score very recent आ गया ना अभी मैं जा रहा हूँ analyze, descriptive and cross tabulation. I want to know about gender and the score. Recent the score.
Okay.
Cell बता रहा हूँ ये स्पीड ले रहा हूँ जस्ट बताने के लिए नाउ सी व्हाट आई गॉट दिस स्कोर नाउ एनीबॉडी मेल एम्प्लॉय जो है मेरा 70 एम्प्लॉय जो मेल है वो 19% नॉट रिसेंट एट ऑल है नाउ सी बेस्ट अबाउट जेंडर वाइज एज वाइज इनकम वाइज यू कैन एनालाइज द थिंग्स इस इज अ रिसेंट स्कोर मैंने किया अब फ्रीक्वेंसी स्कोर भी कन्वर्ट कर दो मॉनेटरी कन्वर्ट करो देन यू डू द एनालिसिस व्हाट इज कंक्लूजन हियर व्हाट इज द मोर इंपॉर्टेंट रिसेंट स्कोर में क्या देखा आपने 17% are very recent, not there. 19 female are taking more assignment in compared to the male. Is it clear now?
So the output page.
Okay, nahi aa raha hai kya?
Nahi, nahi.
Okay. Okay. Now see, is it clear now?
Yes.
Now this is recent score, male, female. So what is the conclusion? I have seen that 17% male have taken very recent assignment, whereas 19% female have taken very recent assignment. In compared to this, I said that female are taking more assignment compared to the male. And out of not recent at all, I have seen the most male employee are not taking any recent assignment in compared to the female. So these 100 employees are a challenge to me. I have to find out who are they. Now similarly, I want to know on the basis of gender department wise. What I found. ये डिपार्टमेंट वाइज आ गया मेरा इंस्टीट्यूट का मैं देखा कि जो कॉमर्स डिपार्टमेंट है 18 आ रहा है इकोनॉमिक्स डिपार्टमेंट में 8 लोग है जो मैंने फैकल्टी डाटा लिया था मैंने क्लियर रिजल्ट वन इंजीनियरिंग इंस्टीट्यूट डाटा लिया मैंने मैं देख रहा हूँ कौन सा इंस्टीट्यूट का एम्प्लॉई डिपार्टमेंट एम्प्लॉई नॉट ऐसे असाइनमेंट कभी डेवलप नहीं कर पा रहा सो इट मीन 77 एम्प्लॉइज आर देयर नॉट टेकिंग एनी असाइनमेंट व्हेयरएज 76 आर टेकिंग एनी आई होप इट्स क्लियर नाउ आई हैव टेकन एनालाइज आई विल गो टू द क्रॉस टेबुलेशन आई वॉन्ट टू नो जो जिसका एजुकेशन क्वालिफिकेशन वाइज व मेरिटल स्टेटस वाइज कुछ चेंज हो रहा है क्या आई कैन डू दैट सो इट मीन्स वंस यू गॉट आर एफ एम स्कोर यू कन्वर्ट आर एफ एम इन टू द वेरिएबल व्यू देन टू एनालाइज इंडेक्स भी निकालो और परसेंटेज वाइज भी इसको कर सकते हैं Now, whenever do any analysis, I will not give more details on regressions. I will explain how we will use this regression in research and in the HR point of view. Now, see, I will explain the whole concept with briefly and how it will use in the HR analytics and HR research. I'll explain that. मैं दो एग्जाम्पल लूंगा. एक लूंगा तो मैं अबाउट सैलरी, हाउ यू डिटरमाइन द सैलरी. सेकेंड आई विल एक्सप्लेन हाउ डेमोग्राफिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स इंपैक्ट ऑन द सैलरी एंड परफॉर्मेंस. आई टेकन टू एग्जाम्पल्स. सो लेट टॉक अबाउट रिसर्च प्रॉब्लम. गिव मी व्हाट इज द रिसर्च प्रॉब्लम हियर. एनीबॉडी? आई वांट टू डिटरमाइन सैलरी. मुझे सैलरी डिटरमाइन करना ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में. ओके, व्हिच इज द फंक्शन ऑफ द फर्स्ट इज कॉल्ड रिसर्च प्रॉब्लम. I want to find out what are the factor impacting on the salary, whether they have given positive impact or negative impact. So I have taken some of the variables, that is salary is equal to function of your experience, number one, number your time spent in the organization, number third, assignment you have taken, number fourth, your qualification, number fourth, is your written score and interview score. Just five layer of me. So, अगर मेरे पास ये information है, तो इस information base में मुझे एक model बनाना है कि मेरा organization में salary structure क्या होगा. अगर एक employee 1x आ रहा है, okay, इसका 10 साल का experience है, और he want to give 20 days तो काम कर 20 hours से काम करना चाहता है per week. And he is already having 3 assignment in last 1 year. He is a BTech, and his written score is out of 30, 20, 20, 20, and interview score out of 20, 15. Which is the score? Another student Y employee. He has 8 year experience. He is ready to work 25 hours in a week. He's already conducted 10 assignment. He is MTech. And written score is 18 and interview score is 14. Can I apply the salary to equally to both X and Y? Yes or no? Or what should be my model? So it means once I develop this model, if I put this variable, I can find out what should be the minimum salary I should offer to the person. Okay, so that there should be no discrimination. That is my simple research problem. So first is called identify your dependent variable, identify your independent variable, and develop a mental framework in your mind. What are the factor affecting the salary? I can use this as a performance also. I want to know performance. The performance of the employee, it depends upon his leave, number of assignments taken, contribution to the organizations, number of training attended, and number of training is imparted. So it means it is up to you how you find a dependent variable, independent variable. Is it clear? The second one is called your model. Here I have taken Y is equal to, Y means a dependent variable is equal to, I will write down beta zero. Beta zero means अगर beta समझ नहीं आ रहा है तो मैं simple एक ले रहा हूँ तो आपके लिए easy हो जाएगा. मैं simple ले रहा हूँ Y is equal to A one plus A two into experience plus A three into time plus A four into assignment, number of assignment, plus A5 written score plus A6 is your interview score. Is it clear? So I want to know out of five which is more impact on salary, whether experience is more impact or time spent in organization is more impact or assignment is more impact. So maine kya kiya, mere organization ke andar it's those employee data hai, existing data jo mera paas hai employee. तो मैंने इस हिसाब से जो भी सैलरी वो लोग पा रहे हैं और इनका एक्सपीरियंस कितना है, कितना रिटर्न स्कोर कितना पाए थे ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम, इंटरव्यू स्कोर कितना पाए थे, कितने असाइनमेंट कंडक्ट कर चुके थे, दैट आई एम हैविंग दिस 300 एम्प्लॉय का 200 डाटा का इंफॉर्मेशन मेरा पास है. व्हाट इज माय ऑब्जेक्टिव? आई वांट टू डेवलप ए मॉडल ऑन बेसिस ऑफ दिस एम्प्लॉय डाटा एंड आई डेवलप ए मॉडल सो दैट इफ ए न्यू एम्प्लॉय जॉइंस ऑन बेसिस ऑफ दिस मॉडल आई कैन ऑफर द सैलरी. So that there should be no discrimination among the employee. That simple as it is. Then the next step is you have to assume certain things. What are the assumption? The first assumption is your A1 is a constant. You know, A2 is experience. I want it should be greater than zero. मेरा answer value greater than zero आना चाहिए. मतलब है अगर ज़्यादा positive रहेगा तो more experience, more salary, less experience, less salary. So this value should be positive because मुझे अगर ले रहा हूँ salary versus experience. एंड आई वॉन्ट देर शुड बी ए पॉजिटिव रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन दिस टू. वट इज पॉजिटिव रिलेशनशिप? अगर एक्सपीरियंस बढ़ेगा तो सैलरी बढ़ेगा, और एक्सपीरियंस घटेगा तो सैलरी घटेगा. सो आई एक्सपेक्टेड देर शुड बी पॉजिटिव रिलेशनशिप. नाउ सेकेंड आई वॉन्ट ए थ्री. ए थ्री इज योर टाइम. आई वॉन्ट दिस शुड ऑल्सो पॉजिटिव. अगर ज्यादा टाइम स्पेंड करेगा आई विल गिव मोर सैलरी, लो टाइम स्पेंड करेगा तो आई गिव लो सैलरी. सो आई वॉन्ट देर शुड बी ए थ्री शुड बी पॉजिटिव इन माई मॉडल. सो ए टू शुड बी पॉजिटिव, ए थ्री शुड बी पॉजिटिव एंड ए फोर. ए फोर मीन्स नंबर ऑफ असाइनमेंट. आई वॉन्ट पॉजिटिव रिटर्न स्कोर, मोर रिटर्न स्कोर आई विल गिव द मोर सैलरी, एंड मोर इंटरव्यू स्कोर आई गुड गिव मोर सैलरी. सो इट मीन्स आई वॉन्ट ऑल दिस फाइव वेरिएबल शुड बी पॉजिटिव इम्पैक्ट ऑन माई सैलरी. नाउ आई एम नॉट टेकिंग ए डेमोग्राफिक वेरिएबल. मैं यहाँ पर जेंडर, एज एंड क्वालिफिकेशन नहीं ले रहा हूँ, दूसरा मॉडल में बताऊंगा. अभी मैं सिंपल ले रहा हूँ कि दीज आर ऑल स्केल डाटा, आई एम हैविंग द डाटा एंड आई वॉन्ट टू डिटरमाइन ए मॉडल. नाउ द नेक्स्ट पार्ट इज कॉल्ड व्हेन यू डेवलप ए मॉडल. हमारे पास तीन पार्ट होता है. एक होता है मॉडल का जस्टिफिकेशन, देन मॉडल का एक्सप्लेनेशन एंड डिसीजन. तीन चीज होता है. यू हैव टू एक्सप्लेन योर मॉडल इज गुड, यू एक्सप्लेन योर मॉडल, यू एक्सप्लेन योर मॉडल एंड ऑन बेसिस ऑफ एक्सप्लेन यू टेक योर डिसीजन. सो आई विल से JED इज आवर पैरामीटर, जस्टिफिकेशन, एक्सप्लेनेशन एंड डिसीजन. सो टिल नाउ व्हाट इज आवर ऑब्जेक्टिव? A research problem is I want to determine the salary. Salary depends upon five factors. I develop a model. I assume the all should be positive. यहाँ पर हमारा होता है first step. Whenever do any analysis, first identify your problem. Second, develop a model. Third, identify your variables. And fourth, you assume. Problem मेरा है salary determination. Model मेरा है salary determination is the function of experience, time. Then assignment, retain score and interview score. And assumption is that I want all A1, A2, A3, A4 and A5 should be positive. The next part is called whether the model is good or bad. It depends upon these three things. Whether the model is significant or not. First is called R-square. R-square means simply मैं बताना चाहता हूँ, this is Y. Okay? Depend variable. This is X1 and this is X2. Another is this is Y. This is X1. This is X2. Which model is good? कौन सा model ज़्यादा अच्छा रहा है? This is model number one. This is model number two. ये Y का dependent variable, ये X1 X2 independent variable. This much of X1 and X2 explained by Y. It means majority of Y is not explained. Here what happened? This much of X1 and this much of X2 is explained. Only small part are not explained. So the percentage of explained by independent variable into dependent variable is called R-square. If R-square is good, but good or bad, if R-square is high, bad or अच्छा है ना खराब है, why is this X1 and X2? Means maximum of Y का variation Y में explain हो चुका है. Is it clear? This is a good model. So we always interested R-square should be high. If R-square is low, like this, it means only small part of X1 and X2 explained by the impact, but majority of impact is not explained by this independent variable. So in a model, we always interested high R-square. So to be a good model, we say that R-square should be greater than 0.60. 60% of variation should be explained by your model, then only it is good. If R-square is equal to 1, can R-square is equal to 1? This is why. This is X1, this is X2. मतलब पूरा का पूरा आपका मॉडल 1 हो जाएगा, which is not possible. So don't give R square equal to 1. And if what is R square 0? R square equal to 0 कब होगा? This is Y, this is X1, and this is X2. Means there is no relationship between X1 and Y. But to a good model, we always want R square should be greater than 0.60. 70 is very good. 780 greater than is excellent. 0.90 is super. 0.95 is very good. And but more one is called fraud. 0.99 आ रहा है ना, हम बोलते हैं फ्रॉड कर रहे हैं. कभी भी मार्केट में 99 बहुत डिफिकल्ट मिलेगा. सो वी जनरली एक्सपेक्टेड दैट आर स्क्वायर शुड बी मोर देन 0.60. सेकेंड इज कॉल्ड एडजस्टेड आर स्क्वायर. व्हाट इज एडजस्टेड आर स्क्वायर? व्हाट हैपेंड, आई हैव टेकन द फाइव वेरिएबल. That is your experience, time, assignment, written score, and interview score. There may be some other variable which we have not taken. Am I right or not? I'm the fifth variable. There are some other variable will not be explained by your model. So at this transfer says that if we add one variable, what is the percentage of variation explained? Maximum percentage of variation explained by the model. अगर मैं एक वेरिएबल यहां पर ऐड कर रहा हूं व्हाट शुड बी द मैक्सिमम परसेंटेज एडजस्ट आर स्क्वायर प्लीज रिमेंबर एडजस्टेड आर स्क्वायर ऑलवेज बी लेस देन आर स्क्वायर कभी भी ज्यादा नहीं होगा क्योंकि डिग्री फ्रीडम प्रॉब्लम होगा बट अगेन टू ए गुड मॉडल एडजस्टेड आर स्क्वायर आल्सो बी ग्रेटर देन 0.60 एंड अनदर थिंग इज वेरी रिमेंबर आर स्क्वायर एंड एडजस्ट आर स्क्वायर शुड नॉट बी डिफरेंस मोर देन 0.005 अगर मान लो आर स्क्वायर आपका आ रहा है 60 0.60 and adjusted R square आ रहा है आपका 0.30 then there is a very bad the difference should not be more than 0.05 to be a good model both should be greater than 0.6 but there should not be any differences high differences this is required 0.60 what is 0.60 0.60 means 60% of variation of independent variable explained इन डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल इधर क्लियर मतलब ये अगर डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल होगा 60% का आर एक्सप्लेन कर रहा है वाले 40% एक्सप्लेन नहीं कर पा रहा है अगर अब अगर आर स्क्वायर 10% होगा व्हाट डज इट मीन एनीबॉडी 0.10 व्हाट डज इट मीन ओनली दिस मच ओनली एक्सप्लेन एंड 90% आर नॉट एक्सप्लेन डू यू थिंक इट इज अ गुड मॉडल आई होप नो सो टू बी गुड मॉडल आर स्क्वायर एंड एडजस्ट आर स्क्वायर शुड बी ग्रेटर देन 0.60 नाउ सेकंड एफ वैल्यू टू बी गुड मॉडल I want F value should be greater than 10. If F value is greater than 10, then I can say that model is significant. Model is significant. So, क्या क्या चाहिए हमको? R square चाहिए 0.60 above. Adjusted R square चाहिए 0.60 above. And F value चाहिए greater than 10. अगर तीन चीज हो रहा है तो जो मॉडल में बना रहा हूं वो significantly explain होगा. Otherwise, not. Any doubt? कुछ क्वेश्चंस आ रहे हैं शायद चैट बॉक्स में देखने पर एनी क्वेश्चन
नो वी हैव अनम्यूटेड द पार्टिसिपेंट्स सो इफ एनीबॉडी विश टू आस्क एनी क्वेश्चंस दे कैन अनम्यूट
सर एक्चुअली डॉक्टर लोपामुद्रा मिश्रा इज आस्किंग व्हाट शुड बी द डिफरेंस बिटवीन आर एंड आर स्क्वायर
आर इज द कोरिलेशन आर स्क्वायर इज वेरिएशन सो आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट आर स्क्वायर एंड एडजस्टेड आर स्क्वायर
No, sir. Actually, right now you just mentioned. I missed that. What should be the difference?
Okay, R square means
R square means adjusted R square and R square difference.
The difference should not be more than 0.05. अगर R square का value 0.67 आ रहा है, adjusted R square अगर आ रहा है 0.52, then there is a problem. It means what is the problem? It means we have to introduce so many variables जो आपको ignore कर रहे हैं. अगर 0.67 और 0.66 or 65, okay, it is good because the difference is within 0.05. The difference should not be more than 0.05. That is a good model, and you go for citation also. We have a citation for this. And what is the F value required? Greater than 10. So again, I'm explaining to be a good model, your R square should be greater than 0.60. Adjusted R square should be greater than 0.60. But difference should not be more than 0.05. F value is greater than 10. Next is called regression coefficient. Regression coefficient means, what is regression coefficient? There are two types of coefficient generally you are having in regression. One is called standardized, another is called unstandardized. If the individual measurement are same, or sara ka independent variable ka individual measurement same rahega, to hum bolte hain standardized karte hain. Standardized means, isko bolte hain beta or standard deviation. Unstandardized means mean value. इसका मतलब है कुछ आपका रुपीस में होगा कुछ आपका स्केल डाटा होगा कुछ आपका नंबर में होगा यूनिट्स ऑफ मेजरमेंट्स आर डिफरेंट फॉर दैट केस वी वांट अनस्टैंडर्डाइज्ड रिग्रेशन वेयर दिस बीटा वैल्यू इज कॉल्ड द मीन नंबर वन प्लीज रिमेंबर इन स्टैंडर्डाइज्ड रिग्रेशन इंटरसेप्ट इज एब्सेंट इंटरसेप्ट नहीं रहेगा बट अनस्टैंडर्डाइज्ड इंटरसेप्ट शुड बी प्रेजेंट वन टू डिफरेंस कोई पूछेगा व्हाट इज डिफरेंस बिटवीन स्टैंडर्डाइज्ड अनस्टैंडर्डाइज्ड सिंपली से दैट We apply standardized when initial measurement are remaining same and the beta value is called the standard deviation. If unstandardized means units of measurements are different nature and beta is called the mean value. Now this beta here, the beta value is called the mean value or impact value. And to be called a significant beta, the beta significant ka hoga jab t ka value 2 se above hoga. जिसका टी का वैल्यू 2 से अब होगा मतलब वो बेटा हम इसको एनालिसिस कर सकते हैं और इसको जनरलाइज कर सकते हैं पॉलिसी के लिए यूज कर सकते हैं। अगर जिसका बिट्टा का टी का वैल्यू टी मीन मीन का सिग्निफिकेंट टी अगर टी बोलोगे तो अलग क्लास हो जाएगा। T is greater than 2 means this beta, whatever we receive, is can be significant analysis for your model. I will explain one example. What is the first one? Salary. Second is experience. Third is sales target, time, training, interest score, and trade score. What is my objective? My objective is to develop a model. So simply, please see, go to analyze. There is called regression and linear. Now see, dependent variable is my salary. And these are my independent variables. Then don't do anything. First, I go for okay. Now see, what is my R square value? 0.974. It means very good model because 97% of the independent variable explain your model. What is your adjusted R square? Again, is very good. 0.970. Difference is very less. So I means I can say that the model is significant and model is very good. Second, you go to check the F value. What is F value here? F is greater than 10, am I right or not? It means all the independent variable can be explained in your model. Okay, so first is called model summary. Yes, first you say, what is R square value? 0.974. What does it mean? 97% of the independent variable explain in your model, which is very good. How much do we need expected? 0.60. Similarly, adjust R square is very good. Again, 0.97.
Yes.
Okay, now I can say that the model is very good. Now go to the F value. What is F value here? Greater than 10. It means whatever the independent variable have taken, that can be justified. So based upon these three value, R square, adjusted R square, and F value, I can clear that the model is explained and model is justified. Now see, there are two things, unstandardized and standardized. So which model I going to explain? Standardized, unstandardized, anybody?
Standardized, sir.
No, because some data are number, some are score, some are timing. So I go for unstandardized. Clear? One is called unstandardized, and if the unit of measurement is same, agar sara number mein hota, mera data mein kya hua? Timing liya maine, score liya maine, aur aapka say number of experience liya maine. Kuch timing mein hai, kuch number mein hai, kuch score mein, rating mein. So since scales are different, I will go by this unstandardized. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now tell me. Don't look about this T-value now. Out of these, which is the positive part on the cell? Which one is the positive part on the cell? Experience, target, time, interest score, and return score is significant depend on the salary. Am I right or not? Which is the highest impact on the salary?
Time.
It means if you spend 1 hour, your salary will increase on an average 0.696 times. Introduction is like this. If you have 1 year experience, then your salary will be increased 0.312 times on an average. Clear? If you achieve one point target, your salary will be 0.309 on an average time increase. But now see, you have the problem is that here training is negative. What does it mean? If you attend one training, means your salary is declining. Is it good or bad?
Bad, sir.
बट रेंडम है तो मैं इसलिए रिजल्ट आ रहा है। बट नाउ इफ यू से व्हिच इज द मोर पॉजिटिव इंपैक्ट ऑन द सेल्स, व्हिच इज द मोर पॉजिटिव इंपैक्ट ऑन द सेल्स, टाइम फॉलोड बाय
सेल्स टारगेट एक्सपीरियंस,
फॉलोड बाय एक्सपीरियंस, देन सेल्स टारगेट, देन इंटरव्यू स्कोर, देन रिटेन स्कोर। ओके, नाउ क्वेश्चन इज कैन दिस वैल्यू इज सिग्निफिकेंट, आई वांट टू चेक फॉर टी वैल्यू। व्हिच वैल्यू? T value should be greater than 2. कौन कौन 2 ज्यादा आ रहा है बताओ? Experience, significant आ रहा है,
sales target, time.
And these 3. It means to be a good model, I have to show only 3 value significant. All are not significant. Is it clear? Now it is 0.00, 0.00, 0.00. अगर मान के चलो, if all value greater than 2, then that is this is a good model. Am I right or not? Hello. For example, timing, you assume that if all t is greater than 2 and significant value is 0000, then this model is a good model. Yes, right or not?
Certainly, sir. Certainly.
Certainly. But now here, since there is a problem, I am not getting all the t values greater than 2. So what I want that model which is being really significantly says that these are the factors which are important cells. So what I will do, I go to analyze, then go to regression, linear, There is a method here. I want to stepwise. When I watch stepwise, automatically I want those model which give a clear picture to me. Now see how many model it derived. How many model it derived? Stepwise mein kitna model derived kiya? Six. The last model is a very good model because now see the R square will be highest. And adjusted R square will be highest. NOI is also be good. And see the result. Sixth number model, all T are greater than 2, significant. Now tell me what is the impact on the cell? Kone kone value impact kar raha hai salary ke liye? Kone kone salary derna hai. Kya kya dekhunga main? What are the things? I will see is experience.
Training.
I will see it timing and return score. If he said, agar training jyada bolega, to isko main negative mein isko dunga. Because I want those person, okay? तो यहाँ पर प्लस मांग के चलो अभी फिलहाल डॉक्टर मेरे प्रॉब्लम है सो सपोज एक एम्प्लॉय मेरे पास आ रहा है फाइव ईयर एक्सपीरियंस है ओके दो ट्रेनिंग लिया है एंड ही वांट टू स्पेंड 10 आवर्स इन अ वीक एंड रिटेन स्कोर इज स्कोर 10 व्हाट शुड द स्कोर व्हाट इज द मिनिमम स्कोर आई कैन गेट एनीबॉडी सपोज थिंक दैट एक्सपीरियंस जीरो ट्रेनिंग जीरो टाइमिंग ही वांट टू स्पेंड 10 मिनट्स एंड रिटेन स्कोर इज 10 हाउ मच सैलरी आई विल गिव What is the minimum salary I will give?
Around 10,000.
What is the minimum salary I will give? What is the minimum salary?
Oh, 2,000.
Matlab, this is organization mein jitna employee hai, on an average 2,000 salary pa rahe. Baki jo variable pa rahe, it's based upon these factors. So it means if a new person is joined to my interest for organization, on an average I will give 2,553, no problem. Okay. Next, I depend, if number of experience are 10 times, I multiply 0.317. Timing, you want to give 20 hours, I multiply 0.774. And return score is scored out of 20, I give 0.169. Then all I can find out, then I can discriminate among the employees and the salary should be justified. So what is the conclusion? I conclude that my salary depends upon more on time he spent organization, followed by the experience and return score. And if the retaining is taken, so it's going negatively. But this is very wrong, the assumptions are not. तो मतलब ट्रेनिंग डाटा मेरा गलत है क्लियर बट दिस शुड बी पॉजिटिव अगर ये पॉजिटिव होगा तो क्या बोलेंगे एनीबॉडी इफ दिस पॉजिटिव आई से दैट ट्रेनिंग इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट ऑन द सैलरी फॉलोड बाय टाइम्स देन एक्सपीरियंस देन रिटेन स्कोर इज इट क्लियर
यस
व्हाट इज द एवरेज सैलरी ऑफर्ड बाय द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन 2000
53
मतलब इफ एवरीथिंग इज जीरो देन आई विल से 2053 एंड अदर्स हैव चेंज्ड बिकॉज़ ऑफ दिस एक्सपीरियंस बढ़ेगा तो सैलरी बढ़ेगा प्लस मान के चलो ट्रेनिंग अभी ट्रेनिंग बढ़ेगा तो सैलरी बढ़ेगा टाइम ज्यादा स्पेंड करो तो सैलरी बढ़ेगा एंड रिटेन स्कोर अगर आप अच्छा स्कोर करोगे तो आल्सो आई गिव द मोर सैलरी दिस इज द क्रक्स ऑफ द रिग्रेशन एनालिसिस इन योर यू कैन अप्लाई दिस इन द परफॉर्मेंस अप्रेजल आल्सो टू टेक सम परफॉर्मेंस पैरामीटर फाइंड आउट द वेरिएबल्स अप्लाई रिग्रेशन एंड फाइंड आउट हु इज द मोर इंपॉर्टेंट परफॉर्मेंस
Sir, you have run the stepwise method and we got six models. So in the sixth model, we got four factors. The two factors that is interview score and sales target is not there. So that means we got a new model now and we have to keep this as a new model.
This is the final model you have to take because what if model suggested that your interview score and another thing is does not impact on your salary because it is more discriminating nature. So they have thrown it out. So those factors which are significant, they can only explain. Clear? Now you can, if you now see the model number one. What it says? Only experience. Okay. But is final? So what is R square value? 0.941. Is it more than model six? No. So I will go choose the model six. That is my final model.
Okay. Basically, every time we need to take the last one, sir.
Always, because now in you see FUL is high in compared to all the models, FUL is higher here.
Yes, sir.
Then your R square is higher here, okay? And adjusted R square will also be higher here. So if all everything is satisfied, then automatically you accept the last model.
Okay, sir.
You can apply this in a performance measurement, you can apply your salary determination, you can also apply for your feedback analysis like this.
So okay. Our framework is changed, sir. We are getting this as a new framework.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Thank you very much. So today we'll discuss about survival, that is to understand churn, RFM, to understand the category of employee, and regressions to know the impact factor on determinations of performance appraisal. There is software called Janovi. Do you want Janovi to find out the things? Now, whenever your Janovi software is there, वहाँ पर एक चीज आएगा आपको यहाँ पर एक तीन कॉलम आ रहा है ना तो यहाँ पर डिफरेंट मॉडल आ रहा है रीटेस्ट एनोवा रिग्रेशन फ्रीक्वेंसी फैक्टर तो ये चीज सारे में जब नया फर्स्ट टाइम आप लोड करोगे ये आपको नहीं आएगा तो आपको क्या करना है यहाँ पर प्लस सिंबल होगा जानवी लाइब्रेरी जस्ट राइट डाउन जानवी लाइब्रेरी जब भी आप लोड करोगे आपको सारा चीज नहीं आएगा दो तीन ही आएगा देन यहाँ पर एक होगा प्लस सिंबल है जानवी लाइब्रेरी वो क्लिक जानवी लाइब्रेरी सब मॉडल विल बी देयर जो भी आपका लिनियर मॉडल सारा मॉडल यहाँ पर आएगा आई वांट साइकोमेट्रिक टेस्ट आई विल क्लिक दैट साइकोमेट्रिक इंस्टॉल मेरे पास ऑलरेडी इंस्टॉल्ड है आई कैन गो फॉर साइकोमेट्रिक आई कैन गो फॉर फ्लेक्स प्लॉट ओके ऑल मेटा एनालिसिस स्कैटर ऑलरेडी मैं इंस्टॉल कर चुका हूँ तो आप इंस्टॉल करोगे तो ऑटोमेटिकली आप यहाँ पर आईकॉन शो होगा आई वॉन्ट ओपन डाटा ओपन कर रहा हूँ ओपन सुबह का काम करता हूँ मैं ओपन एंड डॉक्यूमेंट Open. Now the service are employee, recruitment, timing, status, generation. आ रहा है ना पूरा डाटा शो हो रहा है ना
Yes, yes.
Now see, हम एक्सप्रेसेस में क्या करते हैं वेरिएबल डिफाइन करते हैं और जानवी ऑटोमेटिकली क्या करेगा वो रीड करेगा ओके सपोज आई वॉन्ट टू चेंज द स्केल सपोज टाइम को स्केल चेंज करना है डबल क्लिक करोगे तो इसका यहाँ पर आ रहा है शो हो रहा है ना डाटा वेरिएबल यू कैन राइट ऑन वेरिएबल यू कैन चेंज द स्केल ऑल्सो इज इट क्लियर
Now it's good.
Then suppose I want to go to status, whatever you want to change, you do that. So, mere paas yahan par, I want to survival. Jab survival click karunga, kya puch raha hai mera? What is the first one? Event. Mm-hmm. Status, ko maine click kar diya. I want non-active. Then I want timing, to click kar diya. I want gender. Now see, I want all these values. ऑटोमेटिकली साइड में देखो सारे वैल्यू आ जाएगा पास करोगे यू गॉट रिजल्ट फीमेल सेंसर नंबर डाटा टेस्ट क्लियर इजी है ना डिफिकल्ट है बताओ
आउटपुट डिफरेंट आउटपुट व्यू लाइक एसपीएसएस
ना सेम वन माइनस सर्वाइवल देन इट गिव्स आल्सो द रेफरेंसेस टू रीड मोर मतलब है ये सबसे बेटर सॉफ्टवेयर अवेलेबल है ओके Suppose I want to do some frequency analysis. I click the frequency. I want chi-square test. I want gender and background person. You got chi-square value. Suppose I want to analyze the regression. I'll go open. I'll go for the new data cells. तो यहाँ पर आप लोग क्या करेंगे रिग्रेशन में करूंगा आई गो फॉर लीनियर रिग्रेशन ओके लीनियर रिग्रेशन यू आर हैविंग डाटा ओके यू गो फॉर सपोज आई वांट टू फाइंड आउट द सैलरी बेस्ड अपॉन द जेंडर डिपार्टमेंट जेंडर डिपार्टमेंट बैकग्राउंड ओके लाइक दिस एंड टाइमिंग जस्ट पास इन इट यू गॉट रिग्रेशन मॉडल सिंपली दो चीज आएगा जो आपको चाहिए रन हो रहा है R स्क्वायर एस्टिमेट बीटा टीपी ये ओपन सोर्स सॉफ्टवेयर है डाउनलोड करो एंड यू कैन डू एनी एनालिसिस ऑन दिस यू कैन गो फॉर टी टेस्ट एनोवा रिग्रेशन फैक्टर बिहेवियरल चेंज इज अनदर एचआर का कॉन्सेप्ट है देन यू गो फॉर फ्लेक्सी प्लॉट लिनियर मॉडल दिस इज कॉल्ड मेटा एनालिसिस मेटा मेजर स्टैटिकल सारे चीजें ऑलरेडी अवेलेबल है और बहुत क्रिस्प भी है ज्यादा जो भी जरूरत पड़ेगा वही देगा फालतू चीज नहीं देगा यहाँ
SPSS is giving a lot of things.
But यहाँ पर आपको minimum जो चाहिए वो देगा डाटा.
Oh, wonderful.
Okay. So आज के लिए इतना. Thank you very much. Okay. Any question?
Sir, just last question. This Jamovi, whatever analysis we are doing, it can be produced for publishing and all also.
Yeah. Automatically, because open source में कोई problem नहीं है. SPSS में आपको problem आ सकता है कि you have to explain कि आपने install किया था या आपने license कोई institute से लिया था. For Janovi, it is open source software. You can directly copy and paste your result with references.
Yeah, because open source is also like that.
Yeah, listen, Janovi is the part of R. R package ka ek part hai. Iska background R hai. But R ke liye command dena padta hai hum log ko.
Yes.
But yahan par jo naya aaya hai na, isme command dena zarurat nahi hai. Those who do not know anything about mathematics and coding, they can use Janovi. and without paying a single amount.
Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
You can do SCM also. Yes, you can do SCM, PLS, everything you can do that.
SCM also can be done in this.
Yeah, you can do SCM.
It's in the same way as we do it in MOS.
Yes. और उसमें अच्छा भी आएगा अगर मैं दिखाऊंगा तो अभी मेरे टाइम नहीं है आई हैव सम अदर असाइनमेंट आल्सो सो यू कैन डू असाइनमेंट यू कैन डू अ गुड मॉडल यहाँ पर एक चीज क्या है जो आपको चाहिए रिजल्ट इतना चाहिए उतना ही देगा एक्सपेंसेस क्या करता है यू गॉट लॉट ऑफ मैथमेटिशियन इक्विपमेंट्स के लिए देता है बट यहाँ पर रिग्रेशन में क्या देखा आपने ग्रिड्स जो चाहिए वही देगा आई माय बेस्ट टू एक्सप्लेन द एचआर पार्ट ओके आई डोंट नो हाउ मच आई रिसीव बट आई ट्राई माय बेस्ट
एक्सीलेंसेशन
सर थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर बोथ दिस सेशंस आर क्वाइट यूजफुल टुडे and we got to know about RFM it looks quite easy and handy also for the participants RFM and survival analysis as we know that this is quite useful for the HR professionals so that they can understand the employee churn and they can understand that which category of the employee is doing good for the organization